So in this activity, we're going to look at an acid fast stain, and this is activity 3-8. So the purpose of the acid fast stain is to stain acid fast bacterial cell walls and differentiate acid fast bacteria from non-acid fast bacteria. So again, this is another example of our differential stain. It's going to allow us to differentiate between acid fast positive and acid fast negative. So what is acid fast? What does it mean when we say that the bacteria is acid fast? Well, this refers to the fact that this type of bacteria has a cell wall that is made of 60% mycolic acid. And the bacteria that's going to have this is going to be in the genus Mycobacterium. That's not to be confused with Mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is a different type of bacteria that is extremely small and lacks cell wall. But Mycobacterium has a cell wall made of 60% mycolic acid. Now, that 60% mycolic acid is very sticky and waxy. And the fact that it's sticky and waxy acts as an adherence factor, meaning that it allows bacteria to adhere to surfaces. So, that is one function of having an acid fast positive cell wall. It acts as an adherence factor. It also protects bacteria from phagocytic digestion. And what that means is phagocytosis is a process that the white blood cells do in which they engulf a foreign invader, meaning they send out these extensions and they will engulf bacteria and take them in and then destroy it. So if bacteria are resistant to phagocytic digestion, what that means is either the bacteria is resistant to phagocytosis itself, meaning that because it sticks to a surface, it's difficult for the white blood cell to even do phagocytosis. Or in other cases, it's that the white blood cell can engulf the acid fast positive bacteria, but it can't digest it, meaning it can't break it down. So an example of this would be for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The bacteria that's going to cause tuberculosis, TB. And what ends up happening in patients who have TB is that the bacteria gets into the lungs, and because the immune cells can engulf it but not digest it, meaning they don't break it down, what ends up happening is that your body as a mechanism is going to basically form the scar tissue around the infection. And so that's going to lead to damage to the lungs. And so this acid fast positive cell wall, this mycolic acid, is going to function to protect the bacteria from phagocytic digestion. It also will protect bacteria from dehydration, from drying out. Most bacteria can only live on a surface for about 2 to 3 days without dying. However, Mycobacterium can survive up to 6 months in some cases on a surface. And that's because that mycolic acid is going to protect it from dehydration, from drying out. And then lastly, that mycolic acid is going to protect the bacteria from chemicals, so antibiotics, disinfectants, etc. That mycolic acid is going to protect the bacteria and make it resistant to antibiotics and disinfectants. So, when we look at acid fast stains, one of the things that you have to think about is that that mycolic acid is waxy. It's difficult for dyes to penetrate. Kind of like in the endospore, right? The endospore is a structure that is made of keratin, and it's difficult to get the dye into that keratin structure. So, if you recall back to our endospore stain, what we do to try and overcome the fact that it's difficult to get the dye into the endospore is that we had to steam it with the dye, right? We had to steam it with the malachite green in order to get the dye into the endospore. In the acid fast stain, there are two different methods that can be used to try and get the dye into an acid fast positive bacteria. The first is what's called the Ziehl-Neelsen method. And this is going to use heat as part of the staining procedure. And this is not just heat for heat fixing. Yes, we're still going to do a heat fix step, but additionally, we're going to steam the slide, while applying the primary stain. Carbolfusion is used as your primary stain because it is lipid soluble, meaning it's going to be able to penetrate that mycolic acid. And this is also why we steam it. So again, we are going to combine using a stain that is lipid soluble, as well as combining that with heat to be able to get the carbolfusion in to that acid fast positive bacteria. In this method, the acid alcohol is used as the decolorizer, and this is going to be followed by a counter stain of methylene blue. Because what you're going to see is in this method, when we add the decolorizer, the acid alcohol, acid fast positive bacteria will retain the carbolfusion, but acid fast negative bacteria will not. And so, in order to see the colorless acid fast negative cells, we have to counter stain with methylene blue. So, next we have the Kenyon method. And this is referred to as a cold staining method, meaning that we still do a heat fix step, but we don't steam when we add the primary stain. So, this is a little bit different. It uses a slightly more lipid soluble and concentrated carbolfusion stain. And so, because we use this modified carbolfusion, there's no need for heat. This dye can penetrate the acid fast positive bacteria on its own. Acid alcohol is still used as the decolorizer, and this is going to be followed by a counter stain of brilliant green or methylene blue. And so let's look at it in more detail. How do we do an acid fast stain? So when we do this, we are going to take a slide, and on the slide, we're going to have one water drop. So again, just like we've talked about before, we squeeze water onto our loop, and then we add it to the slide about the size of a nickel. Then we're going to add the bacteria. And so in this case, we have two bacteria that are going to be used. We have Staphylococcus epidermidis and we have Mycobacterium smegmatis. We are going to add this Staphylococcus epidermidis first and Mycobacterium smegmatis second. And for this one, we're going to use a loop to add the bacteria because the Mycobacterium smegmatis is very sticky, and as a result, it's difficult to get it off of the loop. So if you recall, when we do our Gram stain, for example, right? We transfer bacteria to the slide using a needle because we don't want to pick up too much bacteria. However, when we did our capsule stain, we transferred bacteria using a loop because, again, bacteria that produce a capsule, the capsule is very sticky and it's difficult to get the bacteria off of the loop. Same idea here. Acid fast positive bacteria like Mycobacterium, right? Mycobacterium is going to be very sticky and therefore it's going to be difficult to get it off the loop. So we do transfer bacteria in this example using a loop. We're not going to use a needle, we're going to use a loop. When we add our bacteria to our water, again, we're going to spread it out to about the size of a quarter. We are going to air dry it. And then we're going to perform our heat fix step. So we're making our heat fix smear of Staphylococcus epidermidis and Mycobacterium smegmatis. So once we have our heat fix smear, then we're ready to do our staining procedure. And so what we do in our experiment is that we are going to take a beaker of water and we're going to boil it. And when we boil it, then we can put the slide across the top and we can flood it with carbolfusion. So we're basically just going to cover where the bacteria is with the carbolfusion, which again is our primary stain, and we're going to steam it for 5 minutes. So we're going to basically just make sure that during the 5 minutes, the carbolfusion does not dry out. And so we're going to keep adding it to make sure that it's covered for the entire 5 minutes. So we steam with our carbolfusion. Again, by steaming it, we are going to allow the carbolfusion to penetrate acid fast positive bacteria. So at this point, acid fast positive and acid fast negative are both going to stain with the carbofusion. So when we start, they're both going to be pink. After the 5 minutes, we will dump the carbofusion off and we will rinse thoroughly with deionized water. So again, that just means that we're going to squirt the water above where the bacteria is, let it run down. We want to rinse it very thoroughly to get rid of any background for the carbofusion. Then we're going to decolorize our slide. And the decolorization is just like it is for the Gram stain. So you're going to hold your slide at an angle. And in this case, our decolorizer, though, is an acid alcohol mix, acid alcohol. So we just add the acid alcohol to the top and we let it run down the slide. And it's initially going to turn purple. That's expected. But this is going to be done until the liquid running off is clear. Just like in the Gram stain, we do that until the liquid coming off is clear. Similar idea with our acid fast stain. We're going to add the decolorizer until the liquid coming off is clear. That can take about 20 to 30 seconds approximately. After we decolorize, again, we are going to rinse. So we're going to rinse with our deionized water, squirting it above where the bacteria is and letting it run down. After we rinse it, we're going to lay our slide flat and we're going to stain with methylene blue. Methylene blue is going to be our counter stain. We will add the methylene blue for 1 minute. After 1 minute, we're going to dump it, rinse it with deionized water. Now, notice the methylene blue step does not use heat. We are not going to steam it with the methylene blue. The reason for that is that we don't want acid fast positive to take in the methylene blue. So when we start, both acid fast positive and acid fast negative are going to be pink because they both stain with the carbofusion. Then when we do our decolorization step, the timing of this is important, just like the timing of that is important in the Gram stain. We are going to add the decolorizer. And we need to time it properly so that the acid fast negative will lose their primary stain and the acid fast positive would retain it. So notice that at this point, acid fast positive would still be pink, but acid fast negative would be colorless. That's why we have to use our counter stain. That's why we have to use our methylene blue, because we need our methylene blue to stain the acid fast negative. Because they're colorless after decolorization. So you're gonna end up with pink acid fast positive and blue acid fast negative. And so we're gonna look at that in just a minute. Now, the last step says blot top of slide dry with a chem wipe. Typically, what I do is I actually like to wipe the bottom where there is no bacteria with a chem wipe. I often will blot the side, meaning where the bacteria is not. And if at all possible, I try not to blot where the bacteria is. If you're absolutely in a hurry and you must, you can as long as you carefully blot and you don't wipe. If you wipe, your bacteria is going to come right off. But if you blot, it should be okay. For me, I'd rather be safe than sorry. I like to let mine just air dry until all the water is dry. And then view under the microscope. And when I view under the microscope, I need to look at it with 1000x total magnification. Again, that's consistent with most times we look at bacteria. We have to go to 1000x magnification to be able to visualize it. And so this is our procedure for our acid fast stain. This is just an example of the schematic for the acid fast. So again, we're going to take our heat fix smear. Then we are going to add our carbofusion. Now, we don't use the paper that they're describing here. We simply just add our carbofusion while we're steaming it. And then after we add the acid fast positive stain, so after we add the carbofusion and we steam it for 5 minutes, we dump the carbofusion off, we rinse with water. Then we decolorize, right? And we decolorize until the liquid coming off is clear. We rinse with water. We stain with the secondary stain or the counter stain, which is going to be our methylene blue. Then we dump the methylene blue. We rinse it with water. And then we view under the microscope. So this is just showing you what acid fast positive and acid fast negative bacteria will look like. So in the beginning, before we add any dyes, they're both going to start out transparent or clear or colorless or whatever else color you want to call that. Basically, they're not colored. Then we steam with the carbolfution. Notice this one says that it's kind of a reddish purple. Ours is actually not as much. It's not quite red or purple. It's not usually that dark. It's more of kind of a fuchsia color. It's like a bright pink. So at this point, when we add our carbolfution, acid fast positive are going to be pink. Acid fast negative are also going to be pink. So the carbolfution is going to get into the cells. Then we decolorize with our acid alcohol. And when we decolorize with the acid alcohol, again, the timing of that step is important so that we remove the carbolfution from the acid fast negative. The acid fast positive, which has that thick mycolic acid, right, that waxy cell wall, is going to be able to resist decolorization. And acid fast positive are going to stay pink. So at this point, after decolorization, acid fast positive are pink, acid fast negative are colorless or transparent. Then we stain with our counter stain, which is our methylene blue. Remember, we don't use heat, so acid fast positive is going to stay pink. The blue dye is not going to get in without heat, but our acid fast negative, which were colorless from decolorization, are going to stain with the methylene blue because, again, methylene blue is a basic stain. It's attracted to the cells, and therefore, those acid fast negative are going to be blue. So, if we think about our two bacteria that we're using, remember that we were using Mycobacterium smegmatis and Staphylococcus epidermidis. So, what color would you predict the Mycobacterium will be after the acid fast stain? Will it be pink or blue? And the answer is Mycobacterium is going to have mycolic acid in their cell wall and therefore is going to be pink. So the Mycobacterium is acid fast positive and it would be pink. Staphylococcus epidermidis is not a Mycobacterium. Therefore, it is going to be acid fast negative, and at the end of this procedure, it's going to be blue. And so this is our acid fast stain. Now, if we were to Gram stain acid fast positive bacteria, it's not going to work well because, again, in none of those steps do we have a step that has steam associated with it, and the dyes are not going to get in. So for Mycobacterium, you need to stain them using an acid fast stain. So now I'm going to talk about some examples of medically important Mycobacterium. The first is going to be Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Mycobacterium tuberculosis causes lung TB. TB, tuberculosis. So in TB, it's going to cause an infection of the lungs. And there are several ways that we can test for this. If we want to see if somebody has had TB at some point, there are two main tests that are used for this. One is a skin test where they inject under the skin and then see if you have a reaction. And the other is a blood test. However, for both of those tests, that's not testing if there's an active infection. That is just testing for have you ever had TB? Have you ever had tuberculosis? If you want to test if a person has an active infection of TB, meaning it's in the body still, the way that that's going to be determined is by doing what we call a sputum sample. And so a sputum sample is going to be basically a test. Usually it's done in the morning, so when a person wakes up. And it's basically a type of sample collection where you have the patient cough really hard. So they're going to cough really hard and try and get this liquid up. Now, sputum is not saliva. Saliva is from the mouth. Sputum is liquid that comes from the lungs. So if somebody has TB, for example, they're going to have secretions in the lung. And if we can get that person to cough vigorously and to get that sputum sample out and collect that sputum sample can then be cultured to see if bacteria grows. And that sputum sample is going to be acid fast stained. And they're going to take that sample and they're going to acid fast stain it and see if they find mycobacterium in that patient's lung. If so, right, then they have the mycobacterium tuberculosis. They have TB. They have an active infection because that bacteria is actively in the lungs at that time. Mycobacterium leprae causes leprosy. And you might think back to earlier times, leprosy was once believed to have been very contagious, and people would basically stay away from people who had leprosy, thinking they were highly contagious and they were dirty people and they were, low class or they were, cursed or whatever it might be. But we now know that leprosy is actually not very contagious. It's not something that's easily passed from person to person. It does cause skin lesions, so you get these like wounds on the skin. It also leads to nerve damage. So where those lesions are, people start to lose sensation in that part of the body, and that can lead to injury because, for example, patients might, burn their skin, and because of the nerve damage, they don't feel that sensation that it's hot, and therefore it really damages the tissue. And so that is Mycobacterium leprae, causes leprosy. Lastly, we have Mycobacterium smegmatis, which is the bacteria that was used in this experiment. This causes a condition that's called smegma, and it produces an unpleasant odor in skin-skin contact, especially in the genital areas. So typically, it's when, hygiene might not be as good as it should be. If this bacteria sits in like the fold of skin, then it can produce this smegma, which produces a not very pleasant smell. So this is what it would look like when we do our acid fast stain of Mycobacterium smegmatis and Staph epidermidis. Notice that we have these kind of fuchsia, these bright pink. Those are going to be our Mycobacterium smegmatis. They're little pink rods. And then you can see these blue grape-like clusters, Staphylococcus, right? Staphylo refers to our grape-like clusters, our arrangement. Coccus is going to refer to our shape, which is going to be coccus or cocci, which is plural, meaning they're spheres. So our Staphylococcus epidermidis is acid fast negative, it stains blue. And our Mycobacterium smegmatis is going to be our acid fast positive, and it's going to stain pink. Oftentimes, when we do the staining procedure, a lot of times you might not be able to see. This was a good slide in that it was mixed well, but a lot of times Mycobacterium likes to stick together because it's really sticky. And so often what you see is you see these large clumps of pink. Because the mycobacterium is all stuck together and it's in these like clusters. But this is a pretty good example. This is where they're actually spread out. But just be aware if you were to ever see this, sometimes you'll see it as these, bright pink clusters. You don't really see the morphology per se, but you can see like this group of mycobacterium together. And so let's look at our procedure and see how an acid fast stain is actually done. So now I'm going to make my HeatFix smear for my acid fast stain. So I have a slide and I've labeled it with my initials, the date, acid fast, because it's the name of the stain, and then the two organisms that I'm using. So that is Mycobacterium smegmatis and Staphylococcus epidermidis. So I've labeled this. I'm going to put it frosted side up. I've already wiped off with my lab coat. I'm going to use my loop again. Let me just go ahead and re-sterilize. Okay, I'm gonna let that cool. Then I'm going to add my deionized water to my loop and add it to my slide. So let me put my slide out here so that you can see it better. And I'm going to re-wipe it off. There we go. And I'm going to add my water to my loop. And then I'm going to take my loop, oops,
And I'm going to put water on my slide about the size of a nickel. And then I'm going to flame sterilize. Now for the acid fast stain, I am going to add the organisms with a loop. And the reason I'm going to use a loop for this one is, especially for the Mycobacterium smegmatis, that particular bacteria is very sticky. It's difficult to get the bacteria onto the slide. Kind of like in a capsule stain, we use a loop as well. But the idea is that because the bacteria is sticky, we're going to use a loop so that hopefully we can transfer enough of that bacteria. Now, we're going to do the staph epidermidis first. So it's important that you add them in order because the Mycobacterium smegmatis is so sticky. So I'm doing my staph epidermidis first. Flame it. Go in. Pick up a little bit. I don't want a lot. I don't need a big glob on here. And then I'm going to add it to my water. Now you have to kind of work fast so that it doesn't dry out. Okay, so I swirl it in my water. And then I'm going to flame sterilize. And I'm going to let it cool. While that's cooling, I'm going to grab my Mycobacterium smegmatis and I'm going to loosen the cap. So now I'm going to take the cap, pinky and ring finger, flame it, take my loop and go in and pick up the bacteria. Flame it. Swirl it in the water. Again, you want to make sure you really mix it, especially with this one because it's so sticky. Flame this, starting at the base, working towards the loop. Okay, I'm done with my loop. I can set it down and I can take my slide and I can dry it on a slide warmer. And so then once that's dry, then I will do my heat fix step. So now I'm ready to do my heat fix step for my acid fast slide. So I'm gonna take my dried slide and I'm going to pass it through the flame 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And now I'm ready to do my staining procedure. So now I'm ready to stain my acid fast stain. And so remember that I made my heat fix smear. So here's my heat fix smear for my acid fast, right? I added both bacteria. So I added SE, which was Staphylococcus epidermidis, and Mycobacterium smegmatis, which was my other bacteria. And I added it, I air dried, and then I did 3 passes through the flame to do my heat fix step. Now, when I do the first step of my acid fast stain, I need to steam my slide to do this first step. Just like in the endospore stain, you have to steam it. You also have to steam when you do the acid fast stain. And that's because that acid fast cell wall is made of 60% mycolic acid. And that waxy mycolic acid is gonna resist being dyed. So to get the dye to penetrate the cell for acid fast positive, we need to apply steam. And we're gonna use a special dye. And the special dye that we're gonna use for this is going to be carbolfuchsin. It's lipid soluble and it should help to get into that acid fast positive cell wall. So I'm going to carefully take my slide and I'm going to just kind of lay it across my beaker because again, I'm just using this for steam. And again, I'm going to take my carbolfuchsin and I'm going to add it to my slide. Now, just like with the endospore stain, you have to keep an eye on this because we need to steam it for 5 minutes, but we need to make sure that the dye doesn't dry out during the 5 minutes. Now, the carbolfuchsin smells, it has this fennel smell, so it's not the most pleasant smell when you're steaming it, but it does the job in terms of getting into that acid fast cell wall. So I have to let this go for 5 minutes. All right, so after my 5 minutes is up, I'm gonna put my slide on my slide clip. And I'm very carefully going to dump it into my waste container. And I'm going to rinse with deionized water. And you need to rinse thoroughly. Get the back. All right, so now that I've rinsed with my deionized water, the next step is the decolorization. And so to do this, I'm going to use this acid alcohol. And so this is going to be my decolorizer. Just like in the Gram stain, you have to do it until the liquid coming off is clear. So let me set that down. So this is my acid alcohol. I'm gonna hold my slide at an angle. And I'm going to add it until the liquid coming off is clear. Now, sometimes when you do this step, if you're adding it up above where your writing is, your writing comes off, and that's okay. You can just rewrite that on there. Okay, so now my liquid coming off is clear. So I'm going to now rinse with my deionized water. And then just shake the excess water. And then I'm going to add my methylene blue, which is my counter stain. And I'm gonna let my methylene blue sit for 1 minute as the counter stain. While that's occurring, I'm gonna turn off my boiling water because I'm done with that. I only needed it to steam at the beginning. So I need to let my methylene blue sit. After 1 minute, dump your methylene blue, rinse with your deionized water again. And then again, I can take my chem wipe and I can wipe the back. Shake some extra. Wipe the back. I can blot the areas where I don't think there's bacteria. And then I'm just gonna let this air dry. And then I'm gonna view it under the microscope at 1000x total magnification and look at what I see on my slide.